The difficulty that we've had in the UK of the pressured regions of southern Britain having inadequate investment in schools, infrastructure, housing, and so on, alongside the problem of really poor spatial policies for lagging industrial regions and remoter rural regions, means that after Brexit, we really have to have a much more effective spatial policy. The concern would be that for the older industrial regions, the regions in a sense that benefited most from being in the European Union, such as the Northeast and the Welsh Valleys, which voted pretty clearly against being in the Union, we had a failure of UK spatial policy before that, so that actually having a coherent strategic economic development approach that integrates these regions or adjusts them has to finally be done after almost 40 years of deindustrialization. So in that context, regional policy has to be important. At the moment, I'm extremely concerned that the UK government doesn't seem to have thought about what regional policy might look like. And in fact, in the last 10 years, it's been rather edged into regional policy simply because we were in the European Union. In consequence of that, those of us in the regions are very concerned about where national spatial economic policy might go. As for the rural areas in the CAP, when Michael Gove became Secretary of State, he had a clear moment thinking about how rural policy was not the same as agricultural policy, and that the CAP might be used in rather different ways, promoting economic development, ecological services. That was actually, I think, the right way to be going. My concern will be that in the absence of sufficient public spending resource, because we'll have less public resource to spend, that the UK government will go in for a whole series of non-systematic spatial deals. In other words, regional policy and rural policy might become like city deal policy, which might be individually fine, but they don't add up to a coherent system of development for Britain. So I think those of us that are concerned with spatial development are really rather anxious about how things will now develop. I think that the most significant effects will be reduced level of output growth or output growth, and with it reduced resource from the public sector. In the Scottish context, we have an east of Scotland which is prosperous, in which growth rates are quite high, in which focuses particularly around Edinburgh, we have a relatively modern economic base with income levels in the metropolitan region, the region competing effectively. I actually think that it will adjust and thrive regardless of this scenario. In that sense, it's kind of like a mini London. It has these adjustment capabilities. The west of Scotland, much more problematic. We've seen Glasgow finally get to the point of beginning to stabilise its economic base and expand a little. There's going to be a really serious negative shock in the west, in a context where just in a sense stopping Glasgow becoming the Detroit of the UK has been a major challenge. Brexit's not going to help that in any regard. And I think that we have to think very seriously in the Scottish context about how do we connect to Europe, how do we connect to Ireland, how do we, in a sense, reposition ourselves. And I think that will have fundamental issues in relation to the debate about the organisation of Scottish economic policy and indeed Scottish independence. So I think that for us in Scotland, this is just another change in a constitutional dynamic that I think will now continue. I think that in the context of all of the regions and policy, I think we need much more coherent and strategic policies applied at each regional scale and then at scales within them, metropolitan areas and so on. I think in the English context, city deals have induced effective strategic decision taking about investment and the economy in a number of metropolitan areas, missed out in others. At the same time, the broader regional framework for decision taking is weak. I think In the Scottish context, the Scottish Government have actually taken a number of approaches in economic policy, for instance, emphasising inclusive growth, which I think has been a more effective way of thinking about the challenges we have than you would find prevailing, say, in the regions of England. So that I think there are things you can draw from that. I think that there are also things we learn from other areas. I mean, Scotland learns a lot from the Northwest in terms of thinking about infrastructure and the economy and the way that we take things forward. In terms of the kind of architecture of the delivery of policy, I think that in Scotland, institutions are it's still in flux with it, the National Enterprise Agency, which has, I think, again, something that with the scrapping of the regional development agencies in England, I think it's still been to Scotland's advantage to have a Scottish enterprise in play in the field. But I think that there's also the value in local enterprise partnerships, and perhaps that's something we need to learn from other regions in the UK. So I think there's a mix of lessons that I think that what you can see, partly because of its historic dependence on the block grant, and that, in a sense, being reduced, we now have to make our own way to a much greater extent. Strategic economic decision-taking in Scotland now has to be better than at any time in the last century. And I think that we're beginning to put in place some quite effective mechanisms for doing that. So I think that we have to take an outward look at what other regions and other countries are doing. But equally, I think there are things here that should be of interest to other localities.